Welcome to the ASP.NET Core Scheduler Control Tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to manage appointments in the Syncfusion ASP.NET Core Scheduler Control. You will learn how to create appointments for the entire day, set up recurring events, and make appointments read-only. Additionally, you'll see how to block specific time slots and a few additional features for scheduling appointments. First, I open my existing ASP.NET Core application where I've added the basic properties to render the scheduler. To learn more about integrating this scheduler component into an ASP.NET Core web application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application by pressing the F5 key. See, the scheduler component is rendered with the provided appointments. In this example, appointments are defined with specific time slots. To make appointments all day events, add the isAllDay field in the appointment datamata class. In the index page, set the isAllDay to true inside the project discussion appointment. Now you can see the project discussion appointment at the top near the header, representing that the event is scheduled for the entire day. Sometimes, you may need to schedule recurring appointments over a specific time interval. In such cases, use the recurrence rule field with a valid rule string. For instance, if you want to repeat a Scrum meeting appointment for the next 5 days, add the recurrence rule field in the appointment datamata class. In the index page, set the recurrence rule field in the Scrum meeting appointment with a frequency of daily, interval of 1, and a count of 5. This rule ensures the appointment repeats daily for 5 occurrences. You can see these changes here, where the Scrum meeting appointment repeats for 5 days. By default, the edit and delete options are enabled for appointments. If you wish to make an appointment read-only, you need to disable these options. To achieve this, add the isReadOnly field in the appointment datamata class. In the index page, I enable the isReadOnly field for the releaseUpdate appointment. Now, all CRUD operations on the releaseUpdate appointment are restricted. Let me show you how to block a specific time range on the scheduler using blocked events. First, add the isBlock field in the appointment datamata class. In the index page, I enable the isBlock field for the project discussion appointment. Now, any appointment created for a specific time interval will effectively block that time range on the scheduler, and no one can create any new appointments on that day. Next, to show additional information about appointments, we'll enable tooltips. Just add the enable tooltip property and set its value to true inside the event settings property. When you hover over an appointment, a tooltip now displays the appointment details. Notice the appointment datamodel class. It is built in scheduler field names like ID, subject, start time, and more. Since the built-in scheduler fields are used in the model class, I haven't done this field mapping explicitly in the scheduler. Let's see how to bind scheduler data with custom field names. To demonstrate this, I'll rename the appointment data model class fields, subject to summary, start time to start, and end time to end. In the index page, you will notice that all the fields are renamed in the appointment data. You'll notice that the appointments are not added due to the use of custom fields, and explicit field mapping to the scheduler is not done. To bind these custom field names in the appointment data to the scheduler, add the Event Settings Fields tag and map the custom field names to the scheduler built-in fields. add the eField subject tag, and set the name property to summary. Add the eField start time tag, and set the name property to start. Add the eField end time tag, and set the name property to end. The scheduler component now adds the appointments by mapping the custom field names to the scheduler. Finally, I will show you how to change the title of the field labels in the Event Editor window. To update these field labels, let me add the title property and set appropriate values like event, begin sat, and end sat for corresponding fields. Now, take a look at the editor window. It displays the newly defined field labels, event, begins at, and ends at. In this video, I showed you the basic options to work with appointments in an ASP.NET Core Scheduler control. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our ASP.NET Core products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please like and subscribe to our channel.